Got the one prognostic Sphinx here, but the green-black dredge deck kind of put on the map there by Ari Lax and his finish in Cincinnati, originally designed by Conley Woods, Master Brewer. How do we feel about this dredge deck?
I mean, the dredge deck is very linear, and I think Ari's talked about that in some of his articles, that the deck list is pretty tight because it needs every card to function. That said, it does something very powerful. I think right now, there's no other deck in the format that has as much synergy as this deck has.
Yeah, the thing I want to see is if maybe something gets added to this deck to put it over the top in Journey into Nyx. I don't know if we have that card just yet. I just saw Brady start off with an Overgrown Tomb into an Elvish Mystic, but it's a really, really interesting deck, and it is against a deck where we're basically having a creature fight here in Blue-White Devotion versus Green-Black Dredge. The Blue-White Devotion deck does have access to a card like Detention Sphere to be able to break up some of the synergies of the Dredge deck or be able to kill one of the larger creatures. And you see Anderson does pick up a Temple of Enlightenment. Looks like he might drop down a Frostburn Weird here, but this is some real creature combat here.
Yeah, and this is where I like Green-Black Dredge. The deck doesn't particularly play fair. You know, it has cards like Commune with the Gods and Grisly Salvage that set up just great board states for it. It has, in Night Howler, it has cards that can be like 7/7s for 3 when it needs to be. I don't think it fights fair, so I like it in this kind of creature mirror matchup.
Commune does get cast there by Brady. He'll turn over 5 cards, picked up a Mistcutter Hydra. The lands all went into the bin. Of course, Commune from Theros. You can pick up a creature or an enchantment card. Anderson gonna play another Temple of Enlightenment and then drop down another Frostburn Weird. Can't attack, so he just has to pass the turn back, doing a nice job of building up Devotion. This is a Grisly Salvage. This will be 5 cards coming. You see an Overgrown Tomb, an Elvish Mystic, a Golgari Charm, another copy of Mistcutter Hydra, and a Herald of Torment. Somebody found their sideboard cards.
Yeah, I mean, this is really scary for the Blue-White deck. He already has two Mistcutter Hydras, and he played a mana creature and two mana creatures in play. So that's just going to become the game plan now. It's 5/5 Hydra followed by another 5/5 Hydra. Lance has virtually no ways. He has any ways to deal with this overloaded Cyclonic Rift, I suppose.
Yeah, he's got one Cyclonic Rift in his sideboard. Outside of that, nothing really all that great to be able to stop this game plan that Brady has worked his way into. And, you know, it's not the most impressive thing we've ever seen here on coverage, but it looks like it's going to be able to get the job done, as there's a Bind of Thassa, along with 2 attacks from Frostburn Weird. So 2 cards coming there for Anderson. All he can do is just pass the turn back, and he knows he's probably going to get punched in the face for 10 points of damage in just a moment here, as Brady does pick up another copy of Grisly Salvage, quickly taps his mana, plays another Mistcutter, goes and reaches for a die. 5 counters on that one. How about an attack for 10? Anderson's going to go down.
He goes
to 4.
Right, so it's pretty much overloaded Rift or Bust here. My guess is that Lance will draw 2, and he needs to draw both Rift and Nykthos this turn.
Well, I think the way you do that is you have to probably start by attacking with the 2 Frostburn Weirds and hope to hit. Because you see Lance is looking through his hand. He does have Cyclonic Rift in his hand, so that's step number 1.
Yep.
Will Nykthos get it done if he plays it this turn?
I mean, the danger is that, so see, even if he hits that.
And now he's just casting a spell pre-combat.
Well, yeah. I think that took his own out away.
Yeah, and I definitely agree with you. He takes his own out away here. He's going to attack here for 2. He's going to draw some cards.
Okay, it's Mutavault. For a moment there, I thought that was... Yeah, he only plays 1 Nykthos, to be fair. So we're on a pretty slim out.
Got to try to play to it, though. And you see Brady, the reigning standard champion here, saying, well, I'm going to untap and kill you. That's my plan right now. I'm really not going to do anything else. I don't need to cast another spell.
Right. Yeah, this is a difficult situation.
Yeah, and Lance Anderson realizes that, and he's going to concede the game. He did pick up a Mutavault for the turn, but he can't block with it. So Hal Brady is going to win this match over Lance Anderson 2-1. Green-Black Dredge, one of my favorite decks to actually cover because it's so unique, does take it down. We'll see if Hal Brady can actually defend his title here.
Yeah, I mean, that's a pretty impressive showing from Dredge. You know that when Dredge is playing something like Grisly Salvage and Commune with the Gods, when it has that engine set up, it does allow its sideboard cards to become more impactful because it has all these card selection cards. As we saw there, all he really did was he didn't do any graveyard interaction. He played 2 mana accelerants and accelerated into Mistcutter and Mistcutter. He used his graveyard cards just to find those, and 2 ramped out Mistcutters was enough to take down a Blue Devotion deck.
It was about the simplest win I've ever seen over Blue Devotion of, yep, just ramp, cast Mistcutter, and you can't really do anything.
Blue has very few ways to interact with Mistcutter Hydra.
Yeah. We have seen blue decks bob and weave past Mistcutter by, chump blocking with a Mutavault and maybe rapid hybridization of their own creature to provide a green blocker. And as you mentioned, Cyclonic Rift being overloaded, you would assume that Mistcutter Hydra is a big problem for that deck. And we saw in that game, it obviously is.
Yeah. And especially when they're ramped out, you know, like you said, it can bob and weave around it. It basically just has to race Miss Cutter Hydras when they hit the table. And Lance was in no position to start racing there. His board was two Frostburn Weirs. His opponent was still at over 15 life.
Yeah, and the thing you see in Brady's sideboard, which we have in front of us, four copies of Mistcutter Hydra, three copies of Skylasher. It looks like he has no interest in losing to Mono Blue Devotion this weekend.
No, those cards are pretty good against in the Blue-White Devotion matchup. They're also pretty good against Control.